Rabbi Schneider, please.
Shalom. I spoke yesterday about Rashi in Parshas Terumah. It says there about the Tavnis, Amishkan, and the Tavnis of the Kevim, the Chaim Tatsu. If you learn the Parshas of the Mishkan, you see that the new language is like a special Lashon on Migdash. There's tens of words that are used in connection with the Mishkan that are not found anywhere else in the Chumash. So, it's like Hashem created a special Lashon to give over the Tzibui of the Mishkan. And one of the words is Tavnis. But for some strange reason, I don't see anybody in the that tells us what Tavnis means.
Again, I just feel I don't hear what word?
Tavnit and Mishkan and Tavnit Kelab. What does Tavnit mean? But Rashi says that the Chen Tavnit Doris means that the Tavnit of the what Shlomo made, the menorot and the shulchanot have to be the same. So the inference is that Rashi understands tavnit to mean dimensions, the dimensions, the three dimensions, the length, the width, the height, right? By the oren, it says the three dimensions, by the shulchan, by the mizbeach, by the menorah, it doesn't say that. Rashi brings it, say, the chazanti was 18 tfachim. So Rashi understands that Tavnit and Mishkan means the size of the Mishkan. To Rashi, the whole building of the Mishkan. And the Tavnit Kedem means the size of each individual kli. And I should say that the size of the Kedem remained the same. The size of the Mishkan did not remain the same, right? Later on, the Mikdash is much, much bigger. But the size of the Kedem remained the same. And the Ramban seems to be interpreting that no, the Doris means until the time of the Mikdash. That it stood for 479 years, the Mishkan, and the Tavnis of the size of the Mishkan and the size of the Kedem have to always be the same. Now, the Ramban, now we turn to the Ramban. The Ramban, in the first part of Hilchos Beis Bechira, so he's saying there's a mitzvah v'asur b'migdash, and he says this is the Mishkan. It starts with the Mishkan that that Moshe Rabbeinu made, right? And he says the Mishkan is first, but there is Mishkan v'asur Moshe Rabbeinu. Okay. And then he says that when they came into Israel, it was in Gilgal for 14 years, and it was 39 years in the desert. Then they crossed the Yarden, it was 14 years in Gilgal. And then in Shiloh, he says, Ubanisham Bayisha Lavanim Upirsu Yavias and Mishkan Olam. So Raman seems to understand that they didn't use the question at all, and there was one interpretation that there was a question. But after the question, they made like an envelope of Avonah. But the Rambam understands, it seems that there was no question. So it was different. But no Eishashem Tikkur, but there was no ceiling. It took for 369 years, and they came to know Vonisham Migdash. So the Rambam's language of Vonisham Migdash, it seems he understands they actually built a building in Nov. And he says, Uvol the Gibbon, Vonisham Migdash. So again, there was a building in Nov. And then he says about the Migdash in Yerushalayim that's described in Sefer Melachim. And then he talks, he says, Binyan Shabana Shlomo Kevah Mefuish Melachim. And he says the Binyan Ha'atzi is in Sefer Yecheskel. And the Bayit Sheni is like in the middle, it's like a little bit like this and a little bit like that. Now it's described in Maseches Midos. Now, according to Rama, we have seven Maduot. But when they came into Israel, the Mishkan and Gilgal was the same in the Midbar. Shiloh already had a wall of stones. Nov had a building. Gibeon had a building. And Then there's the three in Yerushalayim, the first base of Medrash, the second base of Medrash, and the third base of Medrash. So there's seven. There's seven Madalot. So the Rambam seems to be asking, like Rashi's question, what happens to the Chen Tatu Vadoris? Is 1 through 7 different Madalot? Seven different ways of looking. It was different. Then he answers, he says, in the next halacha, he says, what's the Iker in the Bidin Abayis? He says, there's a Kodesh, and there's a Kodesh HaKadoshim, and there's the Chatzara Mishkan, there's the Azorah. In other words, here the Rambam is like a Pirush Rambam Alachumash. Rambam is saying, what does the Tavnis HaMishkan mean? The post in Shmoyis Kofay says, what does the Tavnis HaMishkan mean? It means that it had a Kodesh Kedoshim and a Chatzar. In other words, the Tavnis, according to the Rambam, is not the size, the dimensions. It's the plan. I think in the Moin of Ruchim, the beginning of the Moin of Ruchim, the Rambam defines different words. I think he says in the Furish. The Tavnis was what we call Tochnis. Tochnit Sheve Tavnis. Tavnit Sheve Tochnit, according to the Rambam. It's the plan, not the measurements. And the measure, the plan was always the same, even though the measurements changed. And then, in the next halacha, in Halacha Vav, he says, no, it's in the English Kevim. He says, there's seven Kevim, right? The Oren, no, he doesn't mention the Oren, Slicha. The Behechel, the Menorah, and the Shulchan, and the Mizbeach HaPnimi, and outside, the Kiyo, the Kana, and the Kevish, and the Mizbeach, the seven. So here, with Adam, with Mamash HaPirush, and the Chumash, he's telling you, what does Tavnis called Kelev mean? It means that the place where these seven kelim are, that the menorah has to be in the right side of the eichel. The shulchan is the left. The mizbech hapnimi is in the middle, and the key of the tana. Each one has its place. Again, according to the Rambam, not like Rashi. Tavnis does not mean measurement. It means place in proportion, in organically connected to the other things. Right? Just like the tavnis amigdish means. Inside is the Kodesh Kedoshim, outside is the Kodesh, which is covered over, and then there's the outside, which is not covered over, which is the Chatzar HaMishkan, the Azora. That's the Tavnis HaMishkan, the place, the organic, how it works out organically, the different things. And the same thing, the Tavnis Kodesh means each tree is a different place. It's organic. Each one, this one has to be to the right, this one has to be to the left. Okay. So we have a basic machlokes Rashi and the Rambam, and the machlokes Rahalocha. According to Rashi, the kelim has to be the same size. According to Rambam, mark it on. Tavnis doesn't mean size. Tavnis means its place in comparison to the others. Okay. So, so that's a very important, I think, a very important distinction, which is hanging on the definition of one word. What does Tavnis mean? And meanwhile, in the Sefer HaMikvah, there's a machlokes. The Rambam says the mitzvah of Atzilut Migdash means, like he just said over here, the building, because the pasuk before says Atzilut Migdash, and he says, Tavnis HaMishkan, the Tavnis Kotelav. That's the perut of what's the Migdash, the Mishkan, the building, and the furniture. It's all one mitzvah, what's the Migdash. But the Ramban disagrees. And it's a Sardis in the Sefer Mitzvah. The Ramban says, no. The Arts of the Migdash is only the building. The Kalim, which are used for Avodah, it's just furniture, they're there for first Avodah. Each tree belongs to the mitzvah. The making the menorah so they can light the menorah. It's a mitzvah to light the menorah. The making the shulchan because it's a mitzvah to put on the lechem aponim every Shabbos. The mizbeach hapnimi because it's a mitzvah to make a teres. The Rambam says that the kelim are not part of the mitzvah of Asur Mikdash. And the Nafkamina is that I guess people are doing the mikdash to pass. Pashas, every day they come in, they make a bracha, shake a shem, it's one of them, there's no tamigdash, right? They can make a bracha satay, which is for the whole day. They're working on the migdash, they're building the migdash the whole day. So according to the Rambam, you can make the bracha, I'm making the menorah, because the menorah is, or the shulchan, And the Kedem, he makes the bracha, but according to the Ramban, no. According to the Ramban, the bracha is only on the building, because that's the putting up the kashim or putting up the stones, because that's the mitzvah, what's the midrash. The menorah and the shulchan are only a hechsher mitzvah, like you don't make the mitzvah when you make the tzitzis, right? That's why tzitzis, you don't make a mitzvah, because it's a hechsher mitzvah, right? So you make the bracha when you like the menorah, but not when you make the menorah. There's an atmina lalocha between the Rambam and the Ramban. And to finish off, I want to say that Bechari Rashi holds like the Ramban. Because if you say that Rashi learned that the Rambam, that it's one mitzvah, so how can it be that half of the mitzvah, Tavnis and Mishkan, can change? But the Tavnis and Kedem can change. How can you split a mitzvah like that in two parts? But if you say it's the Ramban, it's good, because the Avodah never changes. The Avodah is forever. And since the Kedem are there, their whole mitzvah, they're not part of the mitzvah of the Midrash, their whole mitzvah is to be machshir the Avodah, so they came from all the doyos.
Amen, amen. Thank you for these words of Chizuk Ben Amitzarim, Tavshin Ayin Ches, Rabbi Schneider.
Okay, we're waiting. It's no other Chinan, and the Midrash, and 30 other organizations are waiting in the wings to go and do the Beis Midrash.
Amen, amen. Kol Tov, Rabbi Schneider.